Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with a GPU server from Gigabyte, the 4U Gigabyte G492-Z51 GPU Server. If you're looking for a high-performance, GPU-enabled AI, AI training and inference, high-performance computing beast, then continue watching. This platform can support up to 10 double-wide GPUs, is an Nvidia-Certified system, features third-generation AMD EPYC processors, up to 8 terabytes of memory at full capacity, and has an interesting hybrid storage condition. Engage, number one. This would make a great rig for cryptocurrency mining too. I mean, if the bottom didn't just drop out of the market just recently. In the meantime, I suppose if you're looking for another like hard to understand investment opportunity, you could focus on those non-fungible tokens everybody's spending buckets of money on for literally a bunch of pixels that evaporate every time you turn off the power. I don't really get it. What I do know is the Gigabyte G492-Z51 GPU server featuring a next generation motherboard can support a variety of high performance applications like scientific simulation, financial analysis, and other mission critical workloads. It's compatible with the whole family of AMD EPYC processors from Naples to Rome and with Rev A00 Milan. And then there's Milan X with 3D V-cache technology. I don't see that on the map, but Italy in the summer, just beautiful, beautiful. On the front of the system, there are 12 3.5-inch hot-swappable drive bays with 8 amber HDD trays supporting NVMe or SATA, and those 4 blue HDD trays are earmarked for SATA or SAS exclusively, all hot-swappable and supporting HDDs or SSDs. For SAS support, you will need a SAS HBA RAID card. Also located on the front, 2 low-profile PCI Gen 4.0x16 slots and some ports typically found on the back of the system, like 2 10 gigabit Ethernet base T LAN ports alongside the dedicated management LAN port. Then 2 USB 3.0 ports and a VGA port. Next, a few familiar items. The power on button and ID button, both with diagnostic LED, a reset button, non-maskable interrupt button, and then system status LED and HDD LED. Are you interested in the 4U Gigabyte G492-Z51 GPU server? It'd make a great coffee table or something if you weren't going to be placing it on the front line of your network, crunching data down to bite-sized morsels we can consume. Anyways, for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system listed on our site or one that you can configure yourself using our handy-dandy configurator that's priced at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to see more information and start configuring your system today. It smells like freshly baked cookies all of a sudden. Using that MLAN port on the front of the system, administrators can access the system remotely to perform management tasks, get system status, inventory, and a host of other data. Gigabyte provides a few management options, including the Gigabyte Management Console, which comes preloaded on the system and can be used to manage this one server or a small server cluster. Think like one of those Gigabyte high-density servers with quad or dual server sled options in the same chassis. For multiple servers, Gigabyte offers the Gigabyte Server Manager, or GSM. That suite of tools leverages the management console in each Gigabyte server using the GSM agent and provides more tools to manage your network. Both offered at my favorite price for goods and services, free. Turning the system around to the back, there's a low-profile PCI slot on top with 3 80-plus platinum 2200-watt redundant PSUs below. Just under that last PSU, there's an OCP mezzanine card slot for an optional OCP 3.0 card that plugs in once you remove that cover plate. The 3.0 OCP cards are much easier on maintenance too and can easily be removed from the back of the chassis instead of having to take off the cover panel and remove a few risers to access the 2.0 versions. Taking up the majority of the back panel are PCIe cover plates for up to 10 GPUs, 2 of which are mounted horizontally with one behind each of the dual external fan modules. All PCIe slots on this system are PCIe 4.0 compatible, assuming it's running second or third gen AMD CPUs. With the cover panel off, you can see 2 PCIe x16 slots perched on top with the external fans. Those slots can be used for a double-wide GPU or high-performance I/O card. There are several options for I/O with Intel-based and Mellanox-based card options offering 10 gigabit per second, 25 gigabit per second, 40 gigabit per second, 100 gigabit per second, and 200 gigabit per second with dual or single port options. Although for those 100 and 200 gigabit per second cards, they're only available in dual or single port options. The supported PCI bandwidth is also a consideration with options for PCI 3.0 and PCI 4.0. PCI 4.0 offers twice the bandwidth compared to PCI 3.0, so theoretically much faster. In addition to those slots above, an optional OCP 3.0 card can be placed in the x16 mezzanine card slot below the PSUs, also providing up to 4 ports at 100 gigabits per second. This is a dual-root system with 5 of the GPUs running through CPU 1 and the other 5 connected to CPU 2. CPU-to-CPU communication over AMD's Infinity Fabric fills in the communication gap. The Infinity Fabric provides CPU-to-CPU communication bandwidth at up to 18 gigatransfers per second. The architecture of this system also allows for direct GPU-to-GPU access, direct transfers, and GPU-direct RDMA, or remote direct memory access. That means two network computers can exchange data in main memory without involving the processors, and that is where those high-speed I/O controllers come in handy. GPUs supported on this system include the Turing-based T4 and several Ampere-based GPUs, including the A100, either the 40GB or 80GB versions, plus the A10. Also supported are a few RTX cards for graphics support, like the Ampere-based RTX 8000, the RTX 5000, and the RTX 4000. This platform is Nvidia-certified, but also supports a number of other GPU accelerators from AMD, Xilinx, and Qualcomm. Even with AMD EPYC processors delivering 128 PCI 4.0 lanes, there is still not enough PCI bandwidth for all 10 potential GPUs and those 8 NVMe drive bays that also depend on the PCI bus for data transfers, not to mention the OCP mezzanine card slot and that other low-profile PCI slot on top. In order to handle all that PCI traffic, PCI 4.0 switches are used, which provide queuing of data packets. Switching enables the data to be delivered faster by bifurcating the PCI lanes, expanding some and reducing others depending on the current workload, all of which takes microseconds, maybe nanoseconds, resulting in super fast performance. Revision A00 enables the Gigabyte G492-Z51 GPU server to support third generation AMD EPYC CPUs, a definite performance increase over the initial Rev100 configuration that only supported first and second generation AMD EPYC processors. Of course, now we also get compatibility with another CPU architecture, Milan X, which still features the 7-nanometer Zen 3 cores as Milan without the X. Milan X offers true 3D die stacking. When Moore's Law seemed to be at the end of its proverbial rope just a few years ago, you may have been wondering how these manufacturers were going to continue busting out significant CPU upgrades. I mean, Moore's Law proposed that new CPUs would essentially double the number of transistors every 2 years, while everything gets smaller and faster and more efficient too. This 3D stacking technology appears to just stack those smaller units on top of each other for greater density and performance. I mean, skyrise buildings work for inner city developments with skyrocketing real estate prices. Why not computing too? Sticking to the newest processors, you can install either the Milano processors with up to 64 physical cores and 128 virtual threads, PCI 4.0, and an L3 cache limit of 256 megabytes each, or you can go Milan X with the same core count and PCI 4.0 support, but now with up to 768 megabytes of L3 cache for improved performance on highly technical workloads. Think electronic design automation, computational fluid dynamics, and finite element analysis software and solutions. Apparently, these chips are also great for applications in simulation and computer rendering for 3D models, so you have to be thinking, great for game developers too. You do have to wonder if this 3D V-cache technology can be applied in other ways, like maybe 3D V-core technology, where they attach another level of 64 cores on top of the chiplets for 128 physical cores and 256 virtual threads per CPU. Providing the memory for these CPUs are 3DS registered and low-reduced memory modules. I mean, yes, you can go with standard RDIMMs and LRDIMMs, but for the highest memory density on your memory, 3DS modules offer up to 256 gigabytes each. With a 256 gigabyte module installed in all slots, that's a maximum capacity of up to 8 terabytes of memory. Standard RDIMMs and LRDIMMs will only provide half that, with a supported memory module capacity of only 128 gigabytes for a total capacity of up to 4 terabytes with all slots loaded. For a PCIe GPU-based high-performance powerhouse, the Gigabyte 492-Z51 GPU server certainly ticks all the boxes. Support for dual third-gen AMD processors, 10 top-of-the-line GPUs, PCIe 4.0 compatibility, support for up to 8 terabytes of memory, and a few PCIe slots left over for some high-speed I/O traffic. I think we're winning here. You can find this system at IT Creations, along with Gigabyte's other 2U and even 1U GPU server options. And we can also build it out to your specifications and test it so you can drop it into your network right after you receive it. Check out itcreations.com for parts and components too. Oh, and if you've made it this far, hit that subscribe button. Thankfully, 95% of the people who watch our videos are not even subscribed. It does help the channel. Kind of makes me look a little better too, if you didn't hear that. Till next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.